हेलो वेलकम अगेन, वी आर सॉल्विंग गेट 2021 मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग पेपर 2 क्वेश्चन नंबर 13। ए सरफेस ग्राइंडिंग ऑपरेशन हैज बीन परफॉर्म्ड ऑन ए कास्ट आयरन प्लेट हैविंग डाइमेंशंस 300 mm लेंथ एंड 100 mm विड्थ एंड 50 mm हाइट। द ग्राइंडिंग वाज परफॉर्म्ड यूजिंग एल्युमिना व्हील हैविंग ए व्हील डायमीटर 150 mm एंड विड्थ ऑफ 12 mm। द ग्राइंडिंग वेलोसिटी यूज इज 40 m/s। द टेबल स्पीड इज 5 m/min। डेप्थ ऑफ कट कैन कट पर पाथ इज 50 μm एंड द नंबर ऑफ ग्राइंडिंग पाथेज इज 20। द एवरेज टेंजेंशियल एंड एवरेज नॉर्मल फोर्स ऑन ईच पाथ इज फाउंड टू बी 40 N एंड 60 N रिस्पेक्टिवली। द वैल्यू ऑफ स्पेसिफिक ग्राइंडिंग एनर्जी अंडर द अफोरसेड ग्राइंडिंग कंडीशन इज डैश जूल पर राउंड अप टू 1 dB। ओके, विड्थ ऑफ प्लेट इज 10 mm, डेप्थ ऑफ कट इज 50 μm, 50 mm/min, टेबल स्पीड इज 5 m/min और 5000/60 mm/s। ओके, सो दीज आर द विड्थ ऑफ कट, डेप्थ ऑफ कट एंड टेबल स्पीड ऑफ जूल। So, and metal removal rate will be your depth of cut into this speed of table. Okay. So, metal removal rate is this. Okay. And tangential force is given as 40 N. Velocity is given as 40 m/s. So, the power required is this 40 into FT to be, that is 40 into 40. Okay. That is 1600 W. And specific energy is nothing but power by metal removal rate. So power is 1600 and metal removal rate is this 20. So the specific energy is power by metal MRR value is 38.4 joule per mm cube. Okay. Answer is 38.4 joule per mm cube. Okay. In this the number of passes and this length and other dimensions are not here. Okay. Only the thing used are width of plate, depth of cut and table speed. Okay. To calculate the MRR and to calculate power, tangential force and velocity. Okay. So answer is your 38.4 joule per cube. Next, in a pure orthogonal turning by a zero rack angle single point carbide cutting tool, the shear force has been computed to be 400 N. The cutting velocity Vc, depth of cut P is equal to 2 mm and feed S naught is equal to 0.1 mm per revolution and tip velocity Vf is equal to 20 m/min. The shear strength tau S of the material will be dash MPa round up to 2 dB. So here the depth of cut is tip thickness, okay, that is 2 mm. Sorry, the tip thickness is T1 by T2. Okay, T1 is uncut thickness, T2 is tip thickness. And it is equal to Vf by Vc. So, Vf is your tip velocity. Okay, that is 20, because this will be inverse of equal. So total volume will remain constant and so the chip thickness ratio can be the ratio of velocities, okay, assuming the width of the chip is constant. Okay. So material that is entering the metal that is entering the cutting will be equal to the metal will be that will be leaving the machining in a particular time. Okay, so it will be metal entry is T1W into Vc. Okay, that is Vc cutting velocity and metal leaving is T2W to Vf. Okay, so T1 by T2 is equal to Vf by Vac, Vf, Vf. Vf is your chip velocity and Vc is cutting velocity. Okay, so chip thickness ratio can be written like this also. There is 20 by 100, that is 100. Okay. So now we have an R we have zero rectangle as zero, so tangent pi is equal to r cos alpha 1 minus r sin alpha. So r is your 1 by 5 and alpha is your 0, okay, so tangent pi is your 1 by 5, so pi is your 11.3, okay, pi is your 11.3, so we have to calculate shear strength, okay, so 11.3, and shear stress is your shear force divided by Wt by surface, is your shear area, so and F is shear force, and shear force, shear force is given as 400, and W is given and T is given, W is your 0.1 mm and T is your 2, T is your 2, that's your 2, and W is your, that is fluid perforation, okay, T is your this, okay, this is your 0.1 mm. So this is your is and pi your 11.3. Okay, so the shear stress will be 39.99 per mm square. Okay, next, the thickness, width, and length of the metal slab are 50 mm, 250 mm, 3600 mm respectively. A rolling operation on the slab is reduces the thickness by 10% and increases the width by 3%. The length of the rolled slab is dash mm, round off to 1 dash meter. So volume before rolling is equal to volume after rolling. Okay. So the volume before rolling is 50 into 250 into 3600, and volume after rolling is slab is reduced by 10%. Okay. So that is the final dimension of the final thickness of the slab is 0.950, and width increased by 3%. Final thickness of the final width of the slab is 1.0 to 250, and let LF be the final length. So LF can be calculated as 383 by evaluating volume before rolling and volume after rolling. Okay, next. A 76.2 mm gauge block is used under one end of a 254 mm sign bar with a roll diameter of 25.4 mm. The height of the gauge block required at the other end of the sign bar to measure the angle of 30 degree is dash mm. So this is your sign bar, and this is the this is 76.2 mm gauge block on one side, and this sign bar length is your 254 mm, okay, and roll diameter is 25.4, okay, and height of the this angle is 30 degree, okay, so this is, we have this length, okay, we have this angle, so we can determine this h, okay. So H comes out as 254 to 1 by 2. Okay. So okay. So this is your, this is the distance from this point to this point. Okay. And this is your road radius, and this is also your road radius. So H and the distance from the road radius from the top of the gauge to this top of the gauge is H dash. So H dash and H are equal because radius of both the roller are equal. Okay, so H dash is equal to H, and this here, this is your 76.2, and H dash is your 127. The total height required is 127 plus 76.2, that is 203.2. Okay, so that is the total. H dash plus 76.2.